congratulations to Arislandi Lara for knocking out Danny Garcia, or I should say, knocking him down. However, Danny, he signaled to his corner that he's not okay. And that's when his dad ended up stopping the fight. So basically, Danny Garcia quit. That's the nicest way I could put it. He basically waved the white flag in the corner, since he knew if he would have continued the fight, Lara would have had stopped him the next round, since Danny was badly hurt. I mean, I can't even recall the last time I seen Danny Garcia hurt, let alone knocked down. Therefore, congratulations to Arislandi Lara for taking Danny Garcia to school, the Cuban school, while being the oldest Cuban champion in the history of boxing. Arislandi Lara is also the oldest champion in the sport of boxing today. So what he did was highly impressive. For a 41 years old, that's almost 42, to knock out Danny Garcia and make him quit. That's highly impressive. The only thing disgusting about this fight was the commentary. They tried to paint the narrative that Lara was a boring fighter and he's always in boring fights instead of calling the fight. Even though, ironically, it was Arislandi Lara that was aggressive the entire night. And it was Danny who was moving around without punching the entire fight. They call it running. But when Danny was running, they didn't call it that. And they tried to blame Lara for Danny not throwing punches and moving around, even though Lara was the one throwing punches and combos. The commentary was so biased to the point where when Lara knocked down Danny, they couldn't hide how heartbroken they were. Instead of being enthusiastic calling the knockdown, they made it seem like it was a funeral during the fight and after the fight. That's how biased the commentary were. They were screaming, they want excitement. And then when Lara gave it to them, and the cost of Danny Garcia getting knocked out, now they don't want to talk about how the oldest man in boxing just won by KO against Danny Garcia, shutting up all the critics, all the excitement critics, since Lara won by KO. Lara just made everyone eat their words. And after the fight, they interviewed Lara and still talked about how the fight was a slow pace, even though Lara just won by KO. Standing right in front of Danny, applying pressure all night, they still tried to rub the boring narrative all over Lara during his biggest moment. The crazy part about it, they tried to blame Lara for how Danny was fighting to survive. And then when they interviewed Danny, it was a completely different story. We all know what time it is. All this means is that the wrong guy won. The person they was rooting for did not win. This is exactly what's wrong with the sport of boxing. Since Lara has the complexion for the neglection, they throw him under the bus. Meanwhile, Danny, we all know he has the complexion for the connection to get the ultimate protection. He got it. He got it tonight for sure. However, that was not enough, because that ring is the truth teller. They could try to protect you all they want, but they cannot protect you from a beating once you're inside of that ring. With that being said, go ahead and drop your thoughts in the comment section below. What fight you guys want to see Lara in next? I want to see Lara versus Triple G. They both the same age. Triple G avoided Lara prime for prime. So hopefully Triple G is going to grow the cojones to fight Arislandi Lara. Past prime versus past prime. Subscribe below. And to be continued on the next episode of Akhi TV. Peace out. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.